Hello students, in this part we are going to learn about the resonance in LCR circuit. So now the question comes, what is this resonance means? Resonance itself means that something which will enhance, which will gives the amplitude, which will gives the peak, that is called the resonance. Here we are going to discuss about the electrical resonance. What is electrical resonance? As we have seen in LCR circuit, we have the resistance, capacitance and inductance which is connected in series. When these all elements are connected in series, we have observed that the overall resistance of the circuit is represented by the impedance Z. But when this electrical resonance occurs, and what is the use of this resonance? Resonance is basically used where we want to enhance the any of the frequency, any of the oscillations we want to increase, there we need a, or there we use a resonance effect. Sometimes you have understand and you have seen this resonance effect, you can understand the resonance like this. Sometimes you have observed that when the plane is passing over your roof, you have noticed that your window panes are started shattering. Sometimes you have observed when you are moving through a car, and if any DJ or anything comes or it will pass from it, you have observed and you have noticed that your windows are also started shattering. This is just because of resonance effect. So now, what is the condition? This is the condition for the electrical resonance. What is that? It's said to be takes place in LCR circuit when the circuit allows its maximum current. When the current has to be maximum for a given frequency, and the source of alternating supply of the capacitive reactance means that is XC need to be equal to your XL. In this condition we found that the electrical resonance will occur. So as we have already seen that what is the equation for this electrical resonance, we have already know that what is the equation for this, I is equals to we have V upon Z. What does it mean? I is equals to V upon R. So what is the V value? That will be the applied voltage. And what is the value of Z? Z is basically an impedance. That means an overall resistance of the circuit, which is represented by R square plus of L of omega minus of C of omega whole square. Now we are going to discuss that what is the condition and when it happens that when L of omega will equals to L of C. So when the resonance will occur, when the inductive capacitance is equals to inductive reactance, and we have inductive reactance and the capacitive reactance are equal, and this time your for this given frequency the current amplitude will be maximum. So we can say that it's a natural frequency, or the frequency at which the amplitude of the current will be maximum is called the resonant frequency, or we called a natural frequency. Okay, so now we are discussing about the resonance frequency. So as we have already said that it is the frequency at which the current amplitude attains its peak value is called the natural frequency. As we have already seen in the previous, just now I have made it that current is equals to V upon Z. And we have seen what is Z. Z means, if we will see, that means that is the resistance square L of omega minus of omega C whole square. This is the overall impedance of the circuit. Now when this I naught will be maximum, if we are going to see the I naught, so the I naught will becomes to zero when your frequency is tends to zero, or your angular frequency is infinite. In both the case that I naught will becomes to zero, then what is the condition at which we will experience the resonance effect? So we can say that resonance effect will takes place when your omega L minus of omega of C is equals to zero. That means what? It means that omega L will be equals to of 1 upon omega C. See, one thing you have to keep it in mind that this resonance frequency, we cannot have it in LR circuit, or we cannot have it in LC circuit. This is only occurring in LCR circuit. So from here, what I can get is that omega square is equals to 1 upon LC. So I can write here that is omega is equals to 1 upon under root of LC. This I can write down, and this frequency is what we call this, that we call the resonance frequency. This particular frequency is called the resonance frequency because at this point your the amplitude of your current will be maximum, means it will be at its peak. So this is what we call the resonance frequency, and I have already told you what is that resonance means, right? So now if we will see when your impedance means inductive capacitance is equals to inductive reactance, what you will notice that the overall resistance of the circuit will be turns to equal to R. It means here the current and voltage will be in save, because the current, the capacitance and the effect which is caused by the inductor, we found that it is out of phase of 180 degree, then we found that the overall resistance of the circuit is R. Now we are going to discuss this further, that what all cases and what all possible condition of resonance. As we have omega is equals to 1 upon under root of LC, so just now as we have seen that it is the frequency at which the I naught means the current will reach to its maximum amplitude, and the inductive capacitance is equals to your omega of L. That condition we have this case, so we can write it down that is resonance frequency is equals to under root of 2 pi R of this. So we have omega R is equals to under root of LC. Okay, this we can write it down. So finally we will have the expression as FR is equals to 2 pi under root of LC. We have FR is equals to 2 pi under root of LC, and this is what we call the resonance frequency. Okay, so here we are going to discuss the characteristics of the resonance series circuit and its frequency. First one, it says, for quickly now only we can remember this. When the resonance occur, resonance मैंने आपको पहले बता दिया है, जब कोई अपनी natural frequency से something is oscillating, and if we found that another frequency which matches its frequency, what will happen? It will increase its amplitude, and that is what we called its resonance. So resonance occurs, first condition, when the inductive reactance is equals to inductive capacitive reactance. Now what is the resonant frequency? We have already seen that FR is equals to 1 upon under root of 2 pi LC. Now in this case we have seen that impedance is maximum. Okay, means that the impedance will be minimum. Why it will be minimum? Obviously agar current zyada hai to resistance kam hoga, so the impedance will be minimum in the purely resistive circuit. Why it we are saying the purely resistive circuit? One thing you have to make it clear, that resonance only occurs when it is an arrangement of LCR circuit. Only R circuit cannot gives the resonance, but we need a connection, or we need a series arrangement of L, C and R. But this is the condition where inductive capacitance, inductance reactance is equals to capacitive reactance. Now the fourth point says that it has the maximum value of the current when the applied voltage upon resistance, okay, at the resonance. Fifth point is that here, as we have seen, it will be acting as a purely resistive circuit, so the current and voltage both are in phase. Sixth thing, that series resonance can occur at all possible values of R, that can be occurred at any possible values. The voltage across R is equal to the applied EMF, means whatever voltage we are applying, that will be equal to your applied EMF. Now the ninth point, which is I have not written here, that but I will discuss with you, that is the voltage across R is equal to the applied EMF. Third, we have seen that is the voltages across L and C are equal and have a phase difference of 180 degree, so their resultant is zero. What does it mean? The voltage which we have applied across the inductor and across the capacitor, obviously it will be same, right? It will be same. So you will notice that when it is same, so what will happen? In this case, the voltage which we have applied to the capacitor and which we have applied to the inductor, they are out of phase, they are 180 degrees. So what will happen? They will cancel out each other and the overall effect of its voltage will be zero. It means we will have only purely resistive circuit. Next one, you can see that the series resonance circuit is also called the acceptor circuit. Okay, this is also called an acceptor circuit. Acceptor circuit. The series resistor is also called the acceptor circuit. Now we are going to discuss about the sharpness of resonance. As we have discussed and we have seen that what is the resonance and what is the condition to occur the resonance in the circuit. Now we are going to discuss about the sharpness of the resonance. Okay, if we see that is sharpness, as the name given, means something which is reaching to its peak, right? Now the sharpness of the resonance is measured by the coefficient is called the quality or a Q factor. This year they have removed this, but we have to study. That's why we are going to study this particular. If we will see, that is your frequency is independent of the resistance. It has nothing to do with the resistance, what will be the resistance of the circuit. But the sharpness of the peak is depends on the resistance. What does it mean? It means that if suppose we have a curve between a current amplitude I naught, and if I will say that is your omega, that will be your frequency, where omega is equals to your omega r, that will be resonant frequency. So what will be its Q factor? I can make some for you, then we can discuss about it. Here you can see which one, here you can see that the resistance value is low. Why it is the resistance value is low? Because here you can see the current is reaching to its maximum amplitude. It means here the resistance is low, right? Now in the second case you can see, here in this case you can see the resistance is moderate. Okay, not very high, not very low, but it will be moderate. But in the last, where you can find that it is almost appear flat, this is the condition where we have our resistance which will be very high. So we can say that the sharpness of the resonance is defined as in the relationship with the resistance. If more the resistance, it means the sharpness of the curve will be less, and this is what we called a Q factor. Now what is this Q factor? Q factor is defined as the bandwidth which is between the its least to the extreme position. Okay, what it is, I will tell you. Here we are going to discuss about the Q factor. What is that Q factor? Here you can see in this given figure, okay, when we have a series resonant circuit, so it is basically defined as the ratio of the resonant frequency to the bandwidth. What is your resonant frequency? Resonant frequency is the frequency in which the current amplitude will be maximum, obviously. And what will be the bandwidth? Bandwidth, you can understand the two extreme points. Okay, suppose I will say, if I need to find out the bandwidth for this particular, so let it be called omega 1 and let it be called my omega 2. That's why I have written here omega 2 minus of omega 1. What does it mean? It means that this is the path, this is the channel in which I am going to find out its what? Its resonance frequency. Bandwidth, you can understand, that is it is have a such band of frequency which it will allow to pass and it will not allow to pass it. For example, you can understand here the bandwidth is, suppose we have omega 1 as 50 hertz, okay, and we have omega 2 as 100 hertz. So the frequency which will lie between 50 hertz to 100 hertz, that all will allow to pass through it. But or it will gives a resonance effect, we can say, okay, and that is what we called a quality factor. But if suppose yahan pe 49 hai and here it will be 101 also, then too it will not allow this to happen. Why it is so? Because it is the two extreme position, and that is what we called a bandwidth, a proper point or a channel in which we can define that, okay, this will be the minimum limit and this will be the maximum limit of the frequency. This only we are using in the concept of the filters, right? What is that? We allow a such set of frequency to pass through it, and such set of frequency will stop from it. But here in a Q factor, which will define us the two maximum, or I can say the two extreme positions which we are going to consider, and the sharpness between these two frequency will gives us its quality factor. More sharpen the curve, it means that less will be the resistance, and less sharpen the curve, it means what? It means that the resistance will be more and the current will be less. So this is all about the resonance circuits and its Q factor. So I hope this is clear to you. Thank you.